माइक्रोस्कोप. सो इट्स अ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप टू अचीव नैनोमीटर स्केल फीचर्स. ओके सो यू कैन सी दिस दिस इज अ इंसेक्ट. इट्स आई इज बीन फोकस्ड. सो वी कैन नाउ प्रोव आउट अप टू नैनोमीटर स्केल थिंग्स. सो दैट्स वॉट वी रिक्वायर. वी यूज स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. सो वाई वी रिक्वायर इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. सो इफ वी जस्ट एक्सेलरेट इलेक्ट्रॉन विद सर्टन वोल्टेज, वी कैन ऑल्टर इट वेव लेंथ. सो द फॉर्मूला इज रफली इज गिवन बाय लैम्डा इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू अंडर रूट वी, विच वी इज द एक्सेलरेटेड वोल्टेज, एट वॉट वोल्टेज इज बीइंग एक्सेलरेटेड. ओके सो वी कैन कंट्रोल दिस दिस इट्स लैम्डा. सो यू कैन सी नाउ द वेव लेंथ ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन अचीव्ड इज 0.12 एंगस्ट्रॉम. सो वॉट आर द यूज नाउ. The use is, if we see, the resolution is given by lambda by 2, roughly lambda by 2. Okay, so if we use optical light, the resolution can be, so optical light wavelength, if we use 500 nanometer, so then the resolution can have to be 250 nanometer or 0.25 micron. Okay, beyond that we cannot resolve the image. But see, if we have 0.12 angstrom as a wavelength, then we can have much more higher resolution. So that's why we require electron microscope. Okay, so the obvious idea is, why don't we just increase accelerated voltage and then achieve lower and lower wavelength and then have a higher and higher resolution? So that is not possible, that is not feasible. Even though lambda will decrease with the high acceleration, but our image quality cannot be we cannot get. So because we have penetration increase, okay, so the electron will penetrate into sample without coming back. Specimen charging, specimen damage, and image contrast issue. Okay, so up to a certain so we can see optical image, CM image, and TM image. So optical, the resolution is 0.2 micron, magnification is 1000x. SEM, depending upon the whatever accelerated voltage is there, we have our particular wavelength, and then resolution is 0.5 nanometer, and the magnification is 100k. In TM, we have higher acceleration voltage, operating voltage is high, so wavelength is low. And then we have higher angstrom, resolution up to 1 angstrom, and the magnification is 500k. Okay, so now we can see in SEM and TM we have difference of operating voltage, then we have difference in wavelength, and then accordingly we have resolution difference. But that's not the case. SEM operate in scanning mode and TM operate in transmission mode. So in SEM we can have morphological image, whereas in TM we cannot have morphological image. We will have some different type of information in TM, and in SEM we can have different type of information. Okay, so we can do the same thing in SEM also, operating it up to 200k, but we are not doing it because we want to have some different information generated from SEM and different information generated from TM. So we'll discuss those things in when we discuss TM. Okay, so if we see incident photon, whatever incident beam is coming, incident high kV beam is coming, okay, it will, some part of it will be absorbed and some part will be directly transmitted. So this transmitted beam is, this beam will be utilized in UV visible spectroscopy, okay, so to find out what the absorption, okay, that is one case. Second case, out of this incident beam, some part will be elastically scattered. Without any change in energy, it is this incident beam will be absorbed and then reabsorbed with the same frequency without any change. So that is Rayleigh scattering. If it is being absorbed and re-emitted inelastically, that means there is change in energy. So that will be your Raman scattering and all those things. Okay. And if this sample, if this incident beam will generate out X-rays, okay, so we have seen why it generate X-ray in our XPS video, in our XPS discussion. So this characteristics X-ray will be utilized in XPS in Tata. Okay. So out of these, what we are using in SEM, we are using in SEM our interested one are secondary electrons and backscattered electron. So what are those secondary electron backscattered electron? We will see now in detail. So you see, this is our atom, this is our atom position. So there's a nucleus and this electrons in around cell. So some high energy electron will displace the electrons. So once they displace the electrons, so this electron will come out. So those electron which is coming out are secondary electron. Okay. So these electrons, secondary electron, displaced from the outer surface, are highly important for getting a SEM image. Okay, and then some electron which will be like coming out, and then they will be in effect of, so electron is negatively charged, nucleus is positively charged, so this, it will retard, that electron will retard, and they, that can turn back, so that is called backscattered, or it will come near to the nucleus, and due to its electrostatic fields, it can change the direction, and then it will, it is backscattered without any collision, it will back. So those are backscattered electrons. Okay, so they are like, if the nucleus is very heavy, that means it will have a high positive charge, so there is a high possibility that electron will backscattered. Okay, so that will tell out the contrast. If the sample have high somewhere, change in atomic number, sample is like that, we have a different composition with different atomic number, so then that can be resolved by backscattered electron. Okay, so secondary electron and backscattered, so these two are highly important for getting a SEM image, so we will see now in detail. So secondary electron are generated from the collision between the incoming electron and loosely bound outer electrons. Okay, so they have a low energy, so you can see this is the incident electron, and it displaces, this electron displace it, or like it will impart energy, and this electron will become free and come out. So this electron is being captured for imaging the outer surface. So it has a low energy. Only secondary is generated close to surface are topographically important. Okay. So this will be depending upon like work function of the surface, what the work function of the sample is, beam energy, atomic number of the sample, local curvature. So you can see local curvature effect. If it is say like this, only few can few secondary electron come out, but here at this point, huge secondary electrons are coming out. And then this is a detector to detect out these secondary electrons, which have some suitable range of energies. Okay, so this is all about secondary electron. Now for backscattered electron, you can see if the incoming electron is being directly turned back due to this nucleus, or in influence of this nucleus, it turned back. So this is backscattered electron. Okay, so a fraction of incident electron is retarded by electromagnetic field of the nucleus, and if the scattering angle is 180 degree, the electron can escape the surface without any collision. Okay, so it depends upon atomic number of the sample. Okay, if the atomic number is higher backscattering. So this, you can see the secondary, like the images, SEM images out of secondary electrons. So you can see like all the features are being shown. And in backscattered electron, so some of the features are missing. Both are providing us a 2D image of the topography. So there is a color change. There is a grayscale coloring change in the images. Okay? So this is due to the intensity. So this side is very high, whitish. That means electron coming out from backscattered. This is secondary image. Secondary electrons coming out from this edge will be higher. Okay? So, and then the electron, which some dark part, the electrons are coming less, so that are dark parts. So here we can see there is a contrast between these two areas. So this suggests us that these two areas have a like different atomic numbers. So those type of information can be revealed. So now if we see how does the optical microscope work, we have a light source, then we have a sample focused on it, and then we have a couple of lenses to focus it on to generate an image. Okay, this is what our typical optical microscope will be. Now in terms of SEM, we will have one electron gun. So this electron gun will be generating electrons, it will be providing electrons, so that may be by thermally generating or maybe by field emission. So if it is field, like if it is highly provided highly high voltage, then electron will be coming out from the metal, so that is field emission. Okay, and if it is thermally generated, by heating the metal, then it is thermally generated. So depending upon that SEM or SEM, FESEM, field emission secondary electron scanning electron microscopy. So that electron gun generate electrons. Now those electrons are being focused by using some electromagnets. So you can see these magnetic lens are there to focus out that electron beams, and then those electron beams are being, this scanning coil is there to control, to raster scan it. So scanning means to raster scanning it. So to raster scan this electron, to move the electron in a particular direction, in a particular fashion, we have this scanning coil. And then we have this electron colliding with the sample, and then this generating out the scattered electron, back scattered electron and secondary electron. Okay, so secondary electron we are collecting by one particular detector, and then back scattered electron are being collected by some other particular detectors. Okay, and then using these two we are generating the images. So if you see how does it work, if you have a sample, out of the sample it will be like some pixels are being generated area, so that this electron gun will focus on that particular area and then get the information, and then this way it will be moving to different pixels. Okay, and then it will be generating a gray image, gray type of image. So one reading this particular other like this way, it will be generating out a gray scale image. So the signal intensity at each pixel correspond to single number that represent the proportional number of electron emitted from the surface at that pixel location. This number is usually represented as a gray value, and the overall result is black and white image what we receive in our SEM. Okay, so we can see we have this ZNO nanorods. So you can see this is up to 200 nanometer. So the typical tip diameter is around 200 nanometer of these ZNO nanorods. They have a hexagonal edges. So that's what the information like nanometer scale can be achieved from SEM. So I hope now the working of SEM is very much clear to all. If you have any comments, any doubts, you please ask.